Few more bodies back on the ice this afternoon, Coach?
Yeah. Stone nut. He won't be, obviously won't play tomorrow, and highly doubtful for the weekend.
Setback or?
No setback. Just he hasn't been on the ice since it's been the setback. So it's going in the right direction, but it's gonna take a bit more time, I think.
Game day decision on Nate?
Oduya's ready. Thompson, it'll be game day decision. See if today's practice it went well, and now we have to see if it stays well until tomorrow, and then we'll see after warning skate if he's able to go, and from then on we'll have to make decisions on who's ready. Schlappig was also, we're checking if he's healthy, and then we'll have to make a decision on him. And then we'll have to decide if we're going 11-7, we're going 12-6, and so everything's open for tomorrow. The only real no is a Stoner.
Just a maintenance day for Eric?
Yeah.
Goaltender of choice tomorrow, Coach?
We're flipping right now, back and forth, so Condo's going in, yeah.
Is this a plan going forward?
Going forward, we're going to try to give a lot to both, so they don't have to wait a long time before they get their game, and so to continue, getting, their game at the level we know that they can be at. And I think right now, lately, we saw some good portions of games where they look good, so we want to make sure that both of them get the chance to get back in the games fast enough to continue growing.
The goalies, if you see something in a game, might you switch that?
We could. I mean, the guy plays lights out, gets a shutout and everything. I mean, of course, at that point, you want to, but overall, trying to give those guys both a lot of games. It won't be like a necessarily flip-flop every game like that, but it's to answer your question, that's the best way to say it. It's nothing set in stone. It's just we're trying to try to give them both as many games, not far apart, so that they both get, a lot of pucks.
Byproduct, if you guys try to find one of you guys get hot and try to win some games?
Right now, that's not the focus. It's not a question of getting hot and all that. I think right now, we want both of them to be at their best. And we're focused specifically on a few things for both. And with the goaltender coach, we're making sure that we're monitoring what's going great and what needs to continue improving. And we'll see from there. But I think right now for us, it's just it's an ice time thing. We want both guys to get ice time and get games and not be a mental thing.
How do you evaluate the play at the position overall this season? Goalies, both goalies,
what do
they play for you?
Well, I think for the entire team, I think right now we've had some moments where things are good, things are not as good, things are evolving, and I think for us right now it's looking forward. It really is. I can't stay backwards. It's just, if I stay backwards, then I bring my players in a spot where we don't want to be if we want to go forward. So for me, I want to make sure right now that the games that we just played, where we had some long periods of really good goaltending, that that carries on tomorrow, and today was practice time, and the next day. So the same thing as the forwards and defensemen and our special teams and everything else. For us, it's looking forward right now. So that's why at the end of the year, when we reevaluate everything and all the games have been played, I think we're in a better position to see how long things took before some things got to where they should be and so on. But I think right now for me it's tomorrow Anaheim, and we're focusing on that, and today was a major focus on a few things in practice that we wanted to do. So whether it's goaltending, defensemen or forwards, right now for me it's we want improvement.
C'est une journée importante pour la santé mentale. Aujourd'hui, on parle beaucoup de ça. Puis, comme coach qui a un diplôme en psychologie, c'est quelque chose qui tient à cœur. Puis, est-ce que c'est aussi la vie de difficile à quel point?
Moi, ce que j'aime, c'est que je pense que comme société, on commence à mettre beaucoup d'emphase là-dessus parce qu'on comprend que il y a beaucoup de gens qui sont affectés, soit directement parce que ça les affecte personnellement, mais aussi indirectement parce que ça les affecte parce qu'ils ont des gens autour d'eux, des amis, de la famille qui sont affectés par ça. Je pense qu'il y a eu un temps où tout le monde avait un petit peu peur de parler de ça, puis personne ne comprend l'étendue de tout ça, puis il y a une panoplie de problèmes qui sont difficiles à expliquer et à comprendre. Je pense qu'on commence juste à gratter en surface. Là. Et puis, comme société, je pense qu'on s'en va dans la bonne direction. On en parle, puis les gens qui sont atteints de ça sont capables maintenant de dévoiler qui ont besoin d'aide. Puis là, je pense que c'est le début d'une meilleure santé mentale, puis d'une direction qu'on n'a pas le choix de prendre. Que ce soit une santé mentale, une santé physique, c'est directement relié. Puis il faut continuer d'avancer comme société là-dedans. Fait moi, je vais être franc, je suis très concerné, mais pas nécessairement parce que j'ai ma maîtrise en psychologie sportive, mais aussi parce que j'ai des amis, puis j'ai des gens de ma famille qui vivent des affaires difficiles, des situations difficiles, qui ont eu besoin d'aide. Et puis, je sympathie, je comprends, puis oui, c'est très important pour moi, je vais être franc.
Kind of in keeping in that theme, when you're going through a stretch like you're going through, where does fun fit into your job description as a coach?
I don't think it. I think once every day is a new day. Once you understand that, it has to be part of your day. And there's days where you have less, and there's days where you have more. But that's where my job is to make sure that it's today's today. Because I can come in today, not be happy about a goal yesterday or something we didn't do, and I carry that. There's things that you want to improve on and you want to touch on, but especially in tough moments, I think it's important that we understand that this year's a real tough one for so many reasons that you know about and a lot of reasons that you don't know about. And it happens. And my philosophy is very clear. Is you want better, but it's not happening now, which means that we have to take a detour. But doesn't mean we're still not going in the right direction. We know that what we want, we know what we want to be, we know what we can be, and the detour makes us understand a few things and make different decisions that are going to help us go in the same direction we had in mind before a tough season like this year. And you look like there's tons of teams that have lived that. Tampa, for instance, last year, you know, supposed to win the cup. Stamkos gets injured, and all of a sudden things are tougher, and you know, they end up not making playoffs. But this year, you know, they kept their eye on the ball and made a few changes, and then they just got their guys back. And all of a sudden, you know, without changing everything of the core of what they're doing, and you know, they're not doing much different than last year. They just stuck with the plan. And I think that's a model to look at. It really is. And this year they're doing great. And we have to have that poise. We have to be. Mature about this and own up what's difficult, what we can control, and things we can't control, but understand that with this detour, we can do something good with the detour. We can be smart about it and still grow and progress in specific things that are going to help us for now and also for later. And that's my approach. It's every day today. I had individual meetings, team meetings, on ice. The enthusiasm was there. It was a good practice. It was a hard one. Guys responded extremely well yesterday. We start the game, great start, guys are together, the boys haven't lost that. Have they been disappointed before? Yes, but if we sit there in a puddle and feel sorry for ourselves, well then there's nothing growing and we won't figure out anything, and it's important that we do, and that's my job, and that's what I want today to come in. And this was a very good day, very good practice, and it's not just the new guy, it's not just the injury guys that are coming back, it's whoever played yesterday. Things that we can continue to grow on, and that's what's important, and that's how we're gonna make sure that later on, whether it's a short term or long term, that we keep growing and use that detour as something positive that we can draw from to continue making the right decisions and doing the right things to be better.
Thank you.